Hello, everybody, and welcome back. We are about to go into the next stage, which will advance time in the game now. And we'll get to go through what we just went through in the last video directly. So this is stage 3, the hunt, where we get to do it for real. So we need to find the target. So we need to erase all marks that are on here, which I think we have. And we need to leave our fixed position. And we're going to advance time for the tutorial, so we need to please wait. So time is going to advance. Can open up time here, and we just need to wait for this to happen. So there we go, the clock has started running, and this is, I think, just fast forwarding us through the part of this mission, this historic mission option, where ordinarily you would be playing through it. For the purpose of this tutorial, it's fast forwarding to that initial contact that will occur. So that's all that's going on at the moment right now. This is just a fast forward. Now things have slowed down to 32x, the current speed. We're keeping an eye down here on our little piece of information that scrolls to see if we get a report of anything coming in. So they'll do a hydro check now. This is talking us through, and okay, we have a contact, it says. Let's start gathering the information. As this target is long range and slow, let's wait for 20 minutes between bearings. Okay? The longer range, the slower time, we must increase the time waited. Okay. So, please start the stopwatch. So we need to bring the stopwatch back up, and we're going to start the stopwatch, and we are now on the go. And we can see our bearing. So we're waiting for our bearing to come up here, which is a bit backwards, because I would have thought that this bearing would have showed up here by now, but it hasn't. We now have a hydro bearing of 326, so we need to add our course of 90 to it. So 90 plus 326 is more than 360, but it resolves out to 56 degrees. And we can look at this here, if I can pull it out. We are heading 90. 326 is going to be there, and that is 56 degrees. How about that? So now we need to scroll in, or not. Scroll out. Scroll in. And bring this over it. Make sure we're on the center. That is our outside ring is our track heading. The inside ring is our actual true. And we need a 326 is what it was called. So 326 is there, which is that mark there. And now we need to draw that line. There's a little trick we can do here. We can do the protractor. And it doesn't really make a difference where we start the protractor, because we're not really going to be doing anything. We're just going to be lining this up between these two points. And that's that there. And it sometimes doesn't work. Get that to the middle. Click on the middle. Got 20 minutes to do this, so we don't have to panic. And we need to go through that line there and click on it. And now we can use the ruler. And we're still zoomed in. We can use the ruler and we can go out there. And then we can zoom down as much as we can. Zoom up a little bit, but it's 56. You can use 56 off of here as well. That'll also work. And we can go up quite a bit, actually. So it says we need to go out about 50 kilometers, which is crazy business. should be able to go out 50 kilometers here now. 17, 25, this is me learning how to do what I'm doing. 56, well, let's go a bit smaller. And we need to pick this line up. So we're still 56 degrees, which is going to be there. And we're out 66 kilometers now. Well, I'm going to take that. And that is going to be our bearing number one. Scroll back in here and look at our situation. And we can put that on there and see, are we at 56 degrees? And we are, we're maybe 56 point something degrees, but it's good enough for government work. So this we can now move around a little bit if necessary. Might be worthwhile actually bringing this over through 90 degrees, which will be there, and then this will come over onto 56, which would leave 34 on the other side, which is kind of appropriate, right? So we have done our first bearing. Click next when we're finished. Now extend the bearing past our position, which we have. So on the map, we should have something that looks like this, which we do. When you are happy with your first bearing, click next and we'll jump to the next bearing. So we're increasing our time, which is awesome. And I like the fact that it's still walking us through this tutorial. It's not getting in the way. We can also, I think, move this clock sometime. Maybe not immediately. But we're waiting now for this to get around to the 20. Or are we? I guess maybe we are. Maybe we're not. I'm not sure. Because we would have got to the 20 before, but we are now getting into the 20 for our second bearing. And for some reason, I can't move the chronometer. But anyway, time for our second bearing. Okay. Sonar Man is going to give us our second bearing any minute. So, we now have our second hydro bearing, and the contact is on 331 degrees. So we need to turn that into a true bearing on the map. We're travelling 90 plus 331. So if we add those two numbers together in absolute numbers, we've got 331 plus 90 is going to give us 421. And 421 minus 360, because 421 is greater than 360, so we take 360 off it, it's going to give us 61 degrees. Now, 61 degrees is from the north all the way down, so it's going to leave 29 degrees underneath the angle. So if I was to, and I'm kind of taking this to another level now, if I was to make this 29 degrees and extend it out, just for fun, if I was to put the marker on there, if I get it accurately on there, that line should be passing very close through 61 degrees, and it is. The inside circle, remember, is our true, and that is 61 degrees, which means there's 29 degrees to get down, and that's what that angle at the back there is. So I'm just taking the number away, just for my own, you know, fun. Just for my own fun. My own fun! Okay, now this is where this comes in. We had a line here that we drew. So if I pick up the ruler, and I go onto here, we can see that line there. So I need to extend that line through the center to afford me the ability to start another line that goes up here. And it's going to be a kind of a 61 degree line all the way. So I'm going to zoom out, zoom out, zoom out, zoom out. And we're going to put 61 degrees here. So that's 60, 62, 4, 6, 8, 70. 61 degrees is on the mark there. Now we've extended it out 70 kilometers. What about it? It doesn't make a difference. It's good enough for government work. And for some reason we're slightly off on our calculation here as well. Which is interesting. Although that is still 29. So we do note that when we zoom in extensively, it's going to, well, it's going to vary. Now we can take this and we can very carefully extend it out through the point as well in preparation for our third bearing. Our third bearing is going to, we're just going to leave that out of the way for a minute. So this is bearing number one, this is bearing number two. We now have the second hydro, that's done, we're going to extend it, click next when you are done, we is done. We should have something that looks like this. And do we have something that looks like this? I ask thee. If we get that up to there, on that line. Oh no, that's not going to be that. It's going to be this drawing line here. That is passing through. Well, it depends on where you have it on the line, I suppose. But that line is passing through 58, and it should be on 61, so there's something not right. There's something not right. Your map should look like this. I don't know if I'm right here. This is supposed to be down through 61. Let's move that to the, no, that was right. What am I doing? So the true is 61, and it's 61 up in here. Okay, that makes sense. If I was to... Okay, I know now what I do. If I was to turn this all the way around to zero here, and I was to put that back on the line, and I was to bring it down to about there on the line, we're a little bit off the 61, but we're close to the 70, and that was what was in the image. Might need to tune that ever so slightly because my bearing angle might be a little bit off, actually. Which is interesting. But I think it's good enough for now. So we're going to click next, and we're going to increase the time compression and synchronizing tutorial with mission. So please wait. So this information would normally be showing up here from your, you know, from your sonar man. He would, your sound man would tell you contact is closing, contact is constant distance, contact is moving away, speed is slow, medium, fast, and the bearing is a bearing, which would be relative to the front of your boat. You'd have to add the bearing of your boat to that. Time for the third bearing. The third bearing is coming up. And the third bearing is going to be... What is the third bearing going to be? Anybody know? Third bearing... Before we plot the third bearing, we need to move the boat. So, I will now surface the boat. Okay, so they're going to surface the boat.
Sechs Knoten. Neuer Kurs, 180°.
Notice that we're going with große Fahrt. So we're moving on fairly strongly. And we're moving the boat. So that is at the... that's at the 20-minute mark here again. We're moving that boat. And the bearing is going to come in. And... I guess... The nearest sound contact, moving slow, closing bearing 338 long range, is what we need to go and plot, right? We're just going to wait for this to complete for a minute. We have 20 minutes. There's no drama, but we do need to know what the hell is going on. Maybe we need to do this ourselves. So our heading at the time that we took the bearing was 90 plus 338 is 428 minus 360.
Ja, laufen auf beiden Dieselmaschinen.
Telling us that it is a 68-degree bearing. And a 68-degree bearing leaves a mere 22.
Laufen auf
angle.
Beiden Dieselmaschinen. Fahrt bei dem Wetter.
So
Fahrt beträgt 415 Knoten.
So we've set the boat heading on a south heading at 15 knots. We'll get some distance to our to our start point. So be ready for the fourth bearing. Okay. So we need to get ourselves in gear and draw up this third bearing. So we know that we need to be getting down to about 22 degrees here. 22 and 68 is 90, which is kind of what we were after before. So that's drawn there. Then we can take the ruler and we can put it right on the center and we can draw it up this line. In fact, we can reduce everything there, and we know that we're looking for 68 degrees, so we can move that up to there and we get 68 degrees, which is going to be about there, and that is that bearing. So we can now essentially get rid of that because I don't need it. So our third hydro gave us a 338. Okay, we've moved ahead of this. I was waiting for it to come up. So we need to turn this into a true bearing, which we added 90, our course heading to 338, to get 68 degrees. 68 degrees is essentially from here all the way down to here. That's 68 degrees. Another 22 degrees will bring us east. So as the others, we extend past, and that's what we've done. So now, if we zoom out a little bit, we've got these three lines, and they're done accurately. And if we zoom in onto the mark, we can see that they're all passing through the origin there. Slightly looking okay so far. Click next. Your map should now look like this, which indeed it does. I am happy with that. Now we have a lot of plotting to do, so we need to move fast. Let's work out the target heading of our three bearings. The first thing to do is to place a mark high up on the second middle bearing. So, that's relatively straightforward. We go to our pencil, and we zoom in, and we zoom into our second mark, which is about anywhere there, and we put a mark, I would say, there. That's a beautiful mark. It's well done, it's high up. I'm thinking I'm happy with that. Now your map should look like this, and they've put their mark in a similar position, so that's good. And it does. Now, using the compass tool, draw a radius line atop of bearing number 3, and then drag it to mark on bearing 2. This is our first parallel line. Okay, so compass. Put the compass here. Draw the compass down to here, and we need to we need to zoom in. To get this line sitting atop perfectly, and I think that's sitting atop perfectly. Then we can zoom back out, and then we can select the compass again so that it will highlight that line, and we move that onto mark 2. So now we're going to zoom into onto mark 2. Do you see how far off my mark 2 is? It's crazy, isn't it? We can work out where the little dash goes over. We don't have to move them. You know what? Let's just do it. Let's just make sure that the mark is right, because that makes sense. Okay. Now we can zoom back out of there. Basically what we've done is we've taken bearing number 3 and we've paralleled it up here, and we have a point of crossing here. How about that? This is our first parallel line. Tell me when you're finished. We've clicked next. Your map should now look like this, which it does. Do the same for bearing 1. This is your second parallel line. Same deal. So we'll zoom in a little bit. We will get to the compass. We will click on the compass. And then we will draw a line down to somewhere sensible here. We'll zoom right in. Make sure that it's on it. Click. That's good. We'll zoom, 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 zoom. Zoom out. We're not drawing circles here, really. We are drawing circles, of course, but we're not interested so much in the circle as we are interested in the parallel line for this. We pick that up. Now we have to zoom in on that spot, keep the mouse pointer over it, and then we can drop it right on there. And then we can zoom out, and we can see that we have another intersection point down here. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to mark those just for fun, because it kind of seems like the right thing to do. So that's a mark there, and a mark up here. I hope this is right. Boom. So if we click next, then it looks like we have this kind of a line here. So that's similar to what we had. And now we can draw a line between those two marks, and we can measure that track off. And it's the track from the other ship going, so that's why it's this number here, because it's going towards whatever number. That's why the 180 is at the top. Okay, so we do the same thing. So we'll zoom back out. We will pick up our ruler line. We'll zoom back in. And we'll put our stop point there. We'll hold it and we'll zoom back out. And then we'll go to number 3. And we'll stick the mouse over it, and then we'll zoom back in. And now we can extend that a little bit further, and we can watch that line just go to there. And that's what we've got. And now, if we put our compass over that, if we can get it over that, there, we can look and see what that number is. Let's put it up to about there. So the true, so the inside track, north is up here. So we're running about 209.5 degrees, or 210. All right. So now we should have a drawing that's like that, and we do. But now what we can do is draw a circle on here and see, does the circle intersect those two points that I did? So let's do that now. So we go back to the compass, and yeah, this is the mark point here, so we can zoom in on here and do this. And then we can zoom out, go to mark 3. We might need to zoom in onto mark 3. And click there. And that looks like it's going through this mark up here as well. So that is perfect, is what that is. Not just awful bad, it is absolutely perfect. So if we go here, I have this line here, and I can extend this on the 210 mark. So we can extend this as much as we like. So let's extend it a good bit. It was 210, 209.5, I think that was going to be where it is. Now if we zoom in here, now that we do that, move to the next level, it says we drag the circle over where the target crossed bearing 3. Okay, so that's easy done. We go to the compass, we pick up the circle, which is highlighted in red, and we move it, and we need to zoom in here now, because the lines are all over the place, and they're actually slightly wrong, but we need to move it to there, and I need to correct that, because that is, I made a mistake. I got a little bit carried away, so fix that, zoom out, zoom in, pick it up, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out, zoom out, zoom in. We're getting used to this. I need to draw that through that mark there, which will actually line up with the radius, because the radius was on it. So that's that line there. Okay, now we know that this is going to be our predicted fourth, what you call it. So from here it's going to tell us to draw a line from the ship. Next we draw the predicted fourth bearing. This is from our boat, old position, through the center of our dragged circle. Click to remove the image and do it now. Do it now. Okay, so we're back to the ruler. And we're back in on zoom. And we actually have something else we need to do first. We're back to the ruler. We need to grab this point. We need to extend it. Although right now we don't need to worry about it too much, but we need to extend it just so that we can actually get this ruler point on here. And now we're zoom. And we need to go through that point. So we need to zoom, which is there. And you can see the inaccuracy already, can't you? Wow. I think we're good. I'm going to say we're good, because we're like half a degree out, actually, is what we are, which is really amazing, but we are about half a degree out. Anyway, this here is this line. We put the mouser on there, we can see that we're about 88. So we can extend that as far as we like, and it's about 88, which goes through that line there. So this is our now, our predicted line. Right, next, let's tidy up the map by erasing any unneeded lines. Remove the image, do that now, click when you're finished. Right, click when we're finished. Right, half the time I don't know what lines we need to erase, but I don't think we need that line, and I don't think we need that line anymore. There were the parallel ones. Inside of here, I think we're grand. I don't think I need to do much. I'm just going to leave that for now. Now, we will add to our map our position, as it will be when we dive next. So, we run. Our run will be 20 minutes at 15 knots heading south. We look up our speed chart and we find out how far we travel. As soon as we can see, we have traveled 9,260. Well, how does it do that? Well, what it says is we went for 20 minutes at 15 knots, which is, there isn't a 20 here, but there is a 10, so we can double this number. So for 15 knots, that line and that corresponding column is 4,630 meters. That's 10, so double that and we get 9,260 meters. So draw a line now. At this stage must be done precisely. Any error here in our contact information will not be correct when we're finished. Okay. Now, we went exactly 180 degrees, and we need to go exactly 9,260. So we need to extend that line so that we don't have any trouble, and then we need to start another line. So we'll zoom in. Do you see how far out that I've been with that one little extension? It's ridiculous. It is really ridiculous. For starters, we've extended too far, and we just need to go that far. That's good. We keep them all together. So that's that. Right. Now we need to go south a distance. So we get that on here. Then we zoom out to there. And we need to zoom out once more. And we need to go 9,200. 9,300. 9,000, and we use the zoom to get there, so that's 9,250 and a little bit. 9,300, 9,250. We're going to be 10 meters out. I'm going to accept that. We're going to put a mark there. Why? Because you know it makes sense. Tell me when we're finished. We is finished. We're increasing to synchronize with the tutorial. We would have been trying to do this all within 20 minutes. And you can tell from the YouTube video timing whether I've been achieving that, anyway near achieving that or not. And I'm not necessarily entirely convinced we have.
Neue Tiefe 2,5 Meter.
We're 25 meters down. And we're coming up on the time. And it looks like we have a radio message. The British are laying mines. Damn it. So we're on our way down to a depth of 25 meters. We are not there yet, but we will get there. And we are about a minute away from our 20-minute mark, I think. Which
Tiefe beträgt 1,0 Meter.
Wir haben 15 Meter mehr. Again. So what's our map drawing looking like right now?
Diesel Maschine stop.
We might need to extend this line.
Maschinen stop. Tiefe beträgt 2,0 Meter.
Neuer Kontakt. Frachter mit schneller Fahrt. Näher kommend. Peilung 2,3,4. In großer Entfernung.
Right, okay. So, what does that say? That says that our fourth bearing is 2,0 234 degrees off of our bow. Now, we were heading due south to make numbers nice and easy, so that's 180 this time, not 90. We were going east before, we're going south now. So if we add those two numbers together, we will get, obviously, more than 360. So we have to add them together. And we then have to take away 360, and funnily enough, we get 54 degrees. 54 degrees. Huh. Okay. So what does that mean? Well, that means we're going to make a drawing, which is going to look like that, and it's going to continue up, and it's going to intersect a point here on the predicted fourth line. 54 degrees, I hear you say. So, if we try and zoom in here on this, and we're zooming in here on this point down here, which, because we're zoomed in, it's a long way away. Now we can zoom in on it better. So, we're going to take this and we're going to put them right there. Straight over the minute. And we're going to take our marker, and inside true, 54 degrees is where we were going to mark it. And 54 degrees is corresponding with the reciprocal of that, which is 324 degrees. Now, we can do that really quickly with the plus 2 minus 2 rule. So 54 degrees is actually 054. So we can do a plus 2 and minus 2. No, we can't. Forget what I just said. Ignore what I just said. We're going from 54 degrees. So we have to draw out a mark that is 54 degrees, which will correspond with, but will not equal. So the marks will correspond, is what I'm saying. With 222 as it appears on the thing, but 54 degrees doesn't equal 222 at all. If we were to zero these up just temporarily, then we could do the plus 2 minus 2 rule. The plus 2 minus 2 rule is not necessary either, because I'm trying to use an excuse to use the plus 2 minus 2 rule because I think it's great, but we don't actually have to, because we could just do it that way, and that's the 54. Alright, so now we're going to draw a line which is going to start from here. Oh no, we're going to extend that down. It's the same rule, we've got to extend the line, otherwise we'll move it like a dipshit. Now we can start a line from here. Tutorial is good, it teaches you good stuff. And we're going to put that through, but it's kind of 54 degrees. 54 and a little bit. So we'll go with 54. So I'm going to zoom, zoom, zoom. And then I'm going to zoom. And then I'm going to zoom, and we're going to go 54 degrees. And 54 degrees, if we zoom right in, doesn't make much of a difference because we're looking at the same thing. But 54 degrees is about there. What that means is that our crossing point is here on the fourth predictable. And this is our fourth bearing crossing, our fourth predictor, which is given mark 8 as our position. What does that mean? Well, what that means is that, let's see, will it tell us what to do next? Yeah, that's what I expected. So what that means is that this was our heading line, and this was our predicted, and this was our fourth. So this is actually our position. So what we can do now is we can take this and draw it down. We can zoom right in so that we get this accurate. Get that there, and then we can zoom out because we can. And we can pick this up. Oh yes, sir. And we can actually draw that down to there, or we can parallel it over, or we can do whatever the hell we like. Did we draw enough to parallel it? We did. So that's from there. So now we can extend this line a little bit, and I just want to get in on what that line's bearing is. So if we're on there, it's actually a bearing of 210, and it'll be the same bearing of 210 as it always was, of course. So we can start a line there, bring it down through that point, put it on the 210, zoom out, and we can go 210 for as long as we like, which is plenty there. And I've just gone away on the crazy with that. So that is now our position of the boat. And those marks are not necessary. So I will get rid of mark number 7. So that is our position of the boat. And this is the course of our ship. Okay, that it. That is the actual target course. 206 degrees true. My drawings have a different course. My drawings have a course of 210. We're out by 4 degrees. That's a lot. That's a lot. Lesson number one here is accuracy. My accuracy is not good because we're out by 4 degrees. I'm getting 210. The tutorial was getting 206. Over a short distance, that wouldn't amount to a hill of beans. Over a very long distance, and oceans tend to have long distances, that's a big hill of beans. We can now measure the distance between two of those bearings and work out the target speed. Next. Click next when you have measured the total distance between all four bearings. It took 1 hour for the ship to travel that far. Okay. So we can do the ruler, and we can zoom in here onto this point, click on it, zoom out, zoom in here onto this point, and this will be bearing number 4. Oh, and that's why I'm way off. Okay, so that's 16 kilometers. Now I'm going to correct something down here, because we're way off. I think we need to correct something, basically. So I'm going to take that, and then I'm going to zoom. And we're going to go through that mark number 8 a little bit more accurately. And I mean, we probably need to go and learn how to do this better. Mark 8 is there. Oh, I was out by a measure and a half. Does that make any difference to my count? No, it's still 210. Okay. It's still 210. Hmm. 206, incidentally, is here. We're going to stick with 210 because that's the reality of what we were doing. And we're going to see if that is actually going to pay off for us at all, or by how much we're going to miss. So we know we traveled 16 kilometers in an hour. So guess what? If we go here, 1 hour. I got 16. They got 12. Have my measurements been way off? We have bearing 1, 2, 3, and bearing 4. And the distance over that is 16 that I've got. So if I was going with 16, I'm saying that he's doing about 8. 8 is 14. 8.5. He's doing a little over 8 knots in my reckoning because of potential errors that I have in my system. Stage 4, we're set to go for a fast 90. Well, let's do this and see how we get on. Now we plan our attack. Click next. So we need to... here you can see I've extended the target's course and marked how long it will take to get to the attack zone. I have also marked our ambush zone with a distance from our position. So our attack zone is in the green circle. Target is doing 7 knots. We think the target is doing 8. And we need to move from this position into a range here that is what we think might be a comfortable range. Click next. With this, we can find our heading and true bearing. Okay, so the course time, or speed time, to travel time can be reached the ambush zone. So we click next to remove the image. So if we head at 115 degrees at 15 knots, it'll take us 20 minutes to get there. 115 degrees at 20 knots. So, need to hit enter and go back, and then I'll be able to pick that up. 115 degrees. So if we put that on there, move everything so that we can actually see what we're doing. That is there. So 115 degrees is, well, it's here, isn't it? It's 115 degrees. So that looks decent enough. Now, the way we would draw that right angle is we would get our protractor, and we would put it on the line, and it's important to put it on the line. We're getting all accurate now in our last few minutes. And we would get down to... we'll make a judgment here. We can move it. Go from there. Why, Delilah? Why? We need to do that again. Accuracy is going out the window now. That's to there, which I'm guessing is going to be there, and then we go up to here, and we can go through that. So that's 84 degrees, but if we zoom in here, we can see that we are already out by a large count, so we can correctivo that. No. We can see that we are out by a rather large amount here, so we can pick that up, and we can move that back. Till it gets to about 90, which seems to be forever. Now 90 is... which 90? Because there's potentially more than 190. And now we realize that that's frickin' wrong, because that's way out, so we'll put that back to there, which is on the middle. Now it becomes 92, so we now have to backtrack it to get 90 here. That's our... what you call it there. So we can now... oh, no, it isn't. Do you see the problem? That is a pain in the backside. That's to there. So we can fiddle around with this for a while. Until we get to 90 there. So I'm going to split the difference. Call that 89. Grab that and bring it back to 90. That's still 89. The only line that's staying straight is the one that's actually on it. But that's 90 there. Alright. Wow. From here now... we need to extend these lines, don't we? Extend. I have to remember to extend lines. And now we can measure this straight off. There to there. That's 9,050. Now I will surface the boat. So he's going to do that for us. He's going to head off.
Fahrt beträgt 4 Knoten.
Neue Tiefe 0 Meter. Wir gehen nicht 115. We're not going 115. We're going 120. So we're going to end up over here. Which means we're all going to be out by a little bit of a measure. God almighty. This is not going to work. Because my accuracy is out. This is really... we're going to have to come up with some clever solution at the very last minute to compensate for the 4 degrees here and the 3 degrees there and the 5 degrees now here. Anyway, the boat is arising. We are... so our target is coming down this line. We can actually get rid of a whole lot of stuff here now. Get rid of all of that. Don't need any of it. None of it. Not a thing of it. That we can get rid of. We can.
Ja, laufen auf beiden Dieselmaschinen.
Ja, super.
That Fahrt we beträgt 1,4 Knoten.
Geht. Now we can get rid of
Neuer
this.
Kurs 1,15 Grad.
See, I would have gone 120 myself. Only because. Anyway. Get rid of that, we get rid of that. We can get rid of that. We can get rid of that.
Da ist drauf am Horizont. Kurs 2,9,7.
2,9,7.
Alright. So, there we be. That she be good and all, and I like her. Well, yeah. We can get rid of that as well. So here we are with our original position. Excuse me, sneeze.
Neue
here
Tiefe
is our current position.
5 Meter.
And now we are moving in this direction, although we're moving slightly north of this line. And we are getting ourselves for about a 20-minute trip to bring ourselves within range of this target. Now, we haven't seen this target so far all along, and we may never. But this target is traveling down this line, and we've worked that out by all those lines we did earlier, which I think is kind of cool, if it's done correctly. If it's not done correctly, unfortunately, I think we're going to head in for a little bit of failure here. Oh, and all that. So we're increasing TC from
Tiefe beträgt 1,0 Meter.
So we're 1,0 Meter, all stop. Right. 1,0 at 10 Meter, that's our
Diesel Machine stop.
So here we find the 90 degree angle from the target heading. This shows our final heading should be 115 degrees. Not really. Increasing TC and synchronizing to the mission. So
neuer Kontakt, Frachter mit schneller Fahrt, näher kommend. Peilung 2,7,5 in großer Entfernung.
Große Entfernung, aber leider ist es nicht 115 Grad. This is 120 degrees. 115 degrees is up above. So I don't know how this is going to work out, but essentially what we're doing now is we are waiting. We are fiddling our thumbs, waiting for the unsuspecting target to come into our zone of ambush. At which point in time we are possibly going to miss it. But the idea, if you're a professional, capable and more careful submariner, would be to sink it. Get the tonnage and carry on prosecuting your aspect of the war. I think this whole cat and mouse thing is really quite amazing. So toggle your map button to leave the map station. We're in the periscope and we begin our attack, so please go to the attack periscope and go to the station. Okay, so the attack is up here. Up we oh god. Can we please go up the stairs? Zut alors. Isn't this cool? Tell me this is not cool. I think this is cool. Anyway, we are into the attack location. Voila. Now we need to raise the scope. So I'm going to put this over here. So we need to raise the scope fully by clicking that. The second one down. And up she'll go. We're looking, there's the bow. We can just about see the bow disappearing at the bottom of the scope screen. We're 10 meters below. And we're just below. Let me think. Maybe we need to actually up it a little bit more. No, we're just below the water. We're not at 10 meters depth. That's why.
Neue Tiefe 2,4 Meter. Neue Tiefe 9 Meter.
Just go up to 9 meters on the old watchcollars. And that gets us out of the water, which is a help. Now, what does it say? You must sweep the scope until the crosshairs are over the target. So, which way is the crosshair? Which way is the thing going to be? Well, it's going to be up to our right. And there's the target. Heading our way. So, that's actually quite good. Now, hopefully we'll be able to correct for any errors. You can use the mouse wheel to zoom in. Zoom in. Target en route. When over the target, press the space bar to lock. Right, so. Off in Lake Viacona. Spacebar.
Ziel erfasst.
I don't think spacebar is working, is it? Never mind. 1 minute. What do I need to do here? Where's my lock button? I can't remember. Anyway. We want the weapons officer to do this. Okay. Alright. So we click on L weapons officer. And we click on him in the officer's bar and get these options. Voila. And then we need to select follow target. Okay, that's what we needed to do. Alright, okay. Next, we want the weapons officer to identify the target. So, we go to the weapons officer and we say torpedo attack. Has he identified it? Now, torp the attack button. Terrific. Looks like she's a tanker. Yes, she's big. 3 torpedo salvos should do. Okay. Press the L key to move the XO box to the bottom right of your screen. L key. I don't know if that's what it's supposed to be doing. Let's see. Here you can see the torpedo control. Ah, I'm using a mod, so everything is way. Set the dials to minimal. Select salvo.
Umschalten auf Salve.
You can see all 4 tubes have been selected. They have. We are now going. We want to deselect tube 2 to leave the
Rohr
other 3.
Zwei.
Wird geschlossen.
And we want to switch to.
Schalte Aufschlagzünder ein.
Next, we will be ready with the troops. We press flood tube 1.
Rohr 1 wird bewässert.
And
Rohr
3
wird bewässert.
And number 4.
Rohr 4 wird bewässert.
Perfekt. Unglaublich. Now, what do? We wait. Let's lower the scope to just above the water. This will reduce the chance of being spotted. So. Jesus, there's no way we wouldn't have been spotted. So just below the, just above the water, is it? Just above the water, right. Probably a bit too high there, but anyway. Now we want to set our scope to a zero bearing. First, unclick follow target from there. Once your scope is on a zero bearing, looking straight down the bow, click next. You need to go over there to a zero bearing, which is straight down the bow, which is going to be about there. Then we click next. Now we want to set our TDC. First, click the red button in the center, and this will change to green. Oh, it does. Next, click and drag the pointer to 7 knots as per the information from the map work. Right, so 7 knots. And we were calculating 8, but we'll go with the 7 and maybe a little bit. Click next. excuse me, next click on the angle of bow, and we set that to 90, but it's going to be the angle of bow of the target, so it's going to be 90 on the red. Because this is the front of the ship, so it'll be passing us, so it'll be 90 there. Or 91, or 92, or 90. Okay. There we go. Click next. With this method, we need not worry about range. Just leave it as it is. Now lock the TDC by pressing the green button to turn it back to red. Beware as you mouse over any dials that you don't change. The AOB of 90 degrees starboard, green side, and speed of 7. 90 degrees starboard. Oh god, yeah, that's obvious. Stupid me. I was going 90 degrees on my side, but it's actually 90 degrees on the boat side, which is there. Okay. Now it's gone red. Excellent. The tanker will be at straight angles, providing the largest target to hit. Now turn your scope to port until the gyro angle is reading zero. So the gyro angle is down here, to port until it reaches zero, which is there. Click next. I'll check your settings for the gyro angle. I think you're a wee bit out on the gyro angle. It should at least be 258 and 2. So try setting the gyro angle. Yeah. It's 358 and 2. That's right. Three fifty-eight is there. This is not going to allow me to do this, is it? Perfect. Okay, because it was 358 and 2, so... Okay. We'll just move that, haven't I? You gobshit. Get that back to there, and then move it again. Mouse, stop. Perfect. Now I will check your boat is heading in the right angle, which it isn't. Check your heading now. Perfect, it's all done. So now we have to fire the salvo when the ship passes the crosshairs. Right, now, my angle was a little bit further away, so I might let the ship pass a little bit further on the crosshairs in order to afford this the ability to work quite nicely. This concludes the tutorial. Good hunting, click next to end the tutorial, and I will leave you to do stage 5 on your own. Pretty good. So, we are going to drop down.
Neue Tiefe 1-0 Meter.
Because we seem to be being shot at. Which is bad news. So I think they see us. Pretty sure we're not going to survive this. Here are those shots flying past. You think that didn't work? Uh-oh. he saw us and he changed course. And we are getting hammered. Now, if I go to externals, maybe we can see why that is. And the reason why that is because I'm a great big bloody target in here. Unbelievable. This is a fail. This is my boat. This is him. And he has changed course on me. He was supposed to pass down in front of me here, but he saw me with my nose out. And he said, right, balls to this. There's a big ambush here. I'm not going to go into it. And he's moved away. That is good. That concludes this learning experience. It tells you also that in Silent Hunter 5, even in the tutorial when it's a real mission, there are consequences for your decisions. And if you are just going to stick around like a noob, like I am, with your head out of the water, or your head out of the water as much as your periscope out of the water, making a huge big I'm over here target, don't mind me, then you're not going to have a very successful hunt. And they've moved away, changed course, and now we're in trouble. So what I'm going to do, just for the fun of it, is we're going to raise this a little bit, because we can look over here to see where they are, go down to here, tell your man to set course to view.
Neuer Kurs 2-9 Grad.
We'll go full Yankee.
Äußerste Fahrt voraus.
Kleine Fahrt voraus. Stop him. And we're going to be doing a bit of a guesstimation here on distance now. Ugh, I don't remember how to do this. Where's my other... Is this my observation or is this my actual tactical? I don't have the other tools. I was looking for my AOB kind of thing. Well, there's zero. And we're just going to fire all of them. I say, are we going to actually get a hit, or are they... Oh, we're not going to even get a hit, are we? Because I've got a salvo going on, and they are... I don't even know what the range is. I think he's turning. I don't think we're going to have success. I don't think I set the range correctly. He is turning too. That's our lead fish. There's our second fish. Our third fish is definitely off. Our right fish might, if he turns back. And it looks like he might be turning back to his left. So we might actually get a shot here. Or we might get a score here. But if his folks on board have got any eyeballs on him at all, they'll surely see this. He's turning back into it. He's turning back into it. Oh, this is going to be very, very close for this one. Not going to get the second one. But we might be lucky if I don't know what depth I set, actually. This could go anywhere, but... Here we go. We've split it in half. Or have we? Maybe not quite split it in half. Captain, very sorry. Recommend abandon ship. You're in trouble. Gun on the back of that, Jesus. So that was one hit. The other two poissons are heading off in that direction. It's kind of still, it's still going. We've got a torpedo impact. I don't know if one is enough to do the damage, but it certainly started a fire with the crude oil, and the chances are, unless they're able to get that fire under control and patch the damage, things are possibly not looking awesome for this ship. He turned into that. God, all he had to do was keep turning starboard and he would have been alright. All three would have sailed past out here. They're going to keep going for a little bit longer and then they'll run out. There's the damage. We carefully go underwater here. Oh. You can see that there's a big hole there. She's still running. So it may be that if they're able to get this boat under some control, that that section could be kind of managed away, and they might actually limp for quite some time. basically. If we fly in here on the map, we can see that she's a big British tanker. So, Merchant Navy flag. Yeah, the hold is fairly significant. But I'm not convinced we've done enough to sink her, because she'll be she's a tanker, so she's going to be bulkheaded the whole way up and down. So if you lose one of the bulkheads, if the structural integrity is still okay, she'll stay going. Smoke is fairly intense though, and yeah, that's all she wrote. Okay, well, I think that's going to be it for this video. We've had enough fun. We've made some education, and we have to get out of here. And we're hoping that we'll get better at this. Let's go head first down, just freaking everybody out. Let's open up this. How do you up the periscope? Maybe we can't, I don't know. So that ends this. We can close this off, and that's the end of the forward bearing thing. So, c'est ça. Until the next time, folks. Thanks for watching, and we'll try and get better at this.